This screencast is going to demonstrate how to do an energy balance on a reaction using the heat of formation method. There are two methods that you can do an energy balance on a reaction. Previous screencast showed how to do the heat of reaction method. This is the heat of formation method, and if you compare the two, you'll see that the answer is exactly the same. So we're going to use this reaction, all in gas, CO plus H2O goes to CO2 plus H2. And the way to approach this method is first to do the material balances. And that should be your first step whenever doing an energy balance. Then we're going to put together an enthalpy table, and it's going to include the references. And since we are using the heat of formation method, the references have to be the elemental states of whatever make up your molecules. So that would be like carbon solid, O2 gas, H2 gas, etc. And the reason for that is what the method does for the enthalpies is it starts with the elemental species, forms the molecules, and that's where we put in the heat of formation, and then takes them from a reference temperature to their final temperature. Finally, for each enthalpy, the way we calculate it is the heat of formation of that particular molecule, and then the integral from the reference temperature, which is 25 degrees C, and this is always one atmosphere, to the temperature that you're looking for, the C sub P, or the heat of the capacity, dT. If you're doing some kind of reaction that uses ideal gases, you can often look this up in a table, and that means that you don't have to do as many calculations. So we're going to have 1 mole of CO coming in. It's going to have 50% excess H2O, which means that there's going to be 1.5 moles of H2O. We're going to have an 80% conversion of the CO, which means coming out, we have 0.2 moles. The CO2 and the H2 coming out are going to be 0.8 moles, and the H2O coming out is going to be 0.7. So the next thing that we want to do is to draw our enthalpy table. One thing to make sure that you do is you put your references on. And as I said, it's carbon in its solid form, H2 in its gas, O2 in its gas, at 25 degrees C and one atmosphere. And your NN is usually in moles per hour, second, whatever. And your HN and H out as well is in kilojoules per mole. So what do we have? We have CO, we have H2O, we have CO2, and we have H2. We have none of this coming in, and we have 1 and 1.5. Coming out, 0.2, 0.7, 0.8, and 0.8. And so our next job is to figure out the enthalpies that go in the table. So let's start with our first one for carbon monoxide. So our H is going to equal the heat of formation for carbon monoxide plus the sensible heat it takes to go from 25 degrees, which is the reference temperature, to your final temperature. In this case, our reactants come in at 300 degrees and our products come out at 500 degrees. So, since our carbon monoxide comes in at 300 degrees, right now when we've put the heat of formation, our enthalpy is at 25 degrees C. In order to raise it to 300 degrees C, we have to add some sensible heat. And in this case, we go to an enthalpy table of ideal gases, whose references are also 25 degrees C. So we look up at 300 and we find that that's 8.17. We do the same thing for H2O. The heat of formation is minus 241.83. And then using the same table, we look at what it takes to bring it to 300 degrees. Now, the other four enthalpies are products, so they are at 500 degrees. So again, our heat of formation for carbon monoxide, and this time we add 14.38 because it's at 500 degrees. Our H4 again is minus 241.83, and we add 17.01. Our H5 is minus 393.5. That's the heat of formation of CO2. And then we look it up and find that to take it to 500 degrees is 21.35 kilojoules per mole. And finally, here, H2 has zero heat of formation because it's already in its elemental state. And so all we have to add to that is the sensible heat. So when we put these all together, let's put them back into our enthalpy table. So this is minus 102.36. This is minus 232.36. This is minus 96.15, minus 224.82, minus 372.16, and finally 13.82. Since we've included the heats of formation in our enthalpies, now all we have to do to find our Q is the sum of the enthalpies times their number of moles out minus the sum of the moles times their enthalpies in. So what does that look like? And that's everything that came from the right side of our table, which are the products. And so now we subtract from that, and that's going to equal minus 12.6 kilojoules.